Before the season started,
there was the high anxiety
and anticipation for the months to come.
New places, people, adventures, and opportunities.
I had no idea where the journeys would take me.
All I knew
was that it would be filled with challenges.
Challenges that I would have to overcome.
Looking back,
it seems like I always reflect on each previous season
with great memories.
Looking forward to the next
with optimism.
I think this is how every filming season starts.
And like each one before,
there are extreme highs and vast lows.
And thus,
we set out on our voyage.
I spend about
30 weeks chasing my dreams.
Until I can chase no more.
Scattering across the planet.
Thriving, searching,
and hunting for the next new thing.
Whether it be skiing that line,
be a hidden zone of features,
finding a new shot,
or accomplishing a new trick,
never stopping
until I reach my goals, ultimately uprising
from the madness armed with
new and thrilling accomplishments.
And just as it gets darkest before dawn,
when all the challenges faced seem to overwhelm,
hope comes in the form of a familiar element,
a sign of seasons changing,
and the welcoming face of summer warmth.
As I sit here reviewing the great days,
the effort put into the hard days, and the injuries I've recovered from,
I realize this is who I am.
This is what I am here to do.
This is the tale of my season.
My annual reoccurrence of traveling the world
with friends and crews.
In search of my next step, my hopes, my aspirations.
This is the content of my declaration.
Water was running, children were running, you were running out of time. Under the mountain, a golden fountain, were you praying at the glory shrine?
So about mid-March, I got a phone call early in the morning from Mr. Tiblis himself and said that the snow report wasn't reporting all that much, but the mountain reported 4 inches. So we went to the trailhead to try to go to the Crested Butte backcountry, and we got to the trailhead, there was probably about 6 inches. We didn't seem too promising because the base layer was pretty firm at the time, but as soon as we got on the snowmobiles and headed up into the hills, the snow got deeper and deeper and deeper, and lighter and fluffier and more perfect as we traveled into the backcountry.
It was so deep that we weren't even sure what we could do. We had to totally reevaluate everything. Face shots from going straight. What can you say about face shots just going straight? It was way steep. I've got some helmet cam footage where I'm standing on my snowmobile and you can't see the snowmobile. I mean, just completely under. It was epic.
Everyone's got their own agenda. Everyone has a new and unique perspective to offer. So the ideas that come together on any given day, for instance, Ben Ferminsky's constant approach to finding new point of view cameras, it's really fun to watch.
There's 2 days that really shine. Every year I finish my season, there's certain days that I remember. And I got 2 days this year. One, because of the line I was looking at all year, just because of the kind of the intenseness and the fear factor on that one. Tyson and I were hiking. The snow was really variable. We were discussing even going back down. We said, well, we're skiing a different aspect. Let's get up there and look at it. And my line was, you know, full committed line. So once I dropped in, it was kind of felt solid, wind packed, not great snow, but it got better as it went, and just coming out of that line solid was just really rewarding. The other day that really stands out was on Axtell. Of course, as you know, one of my favorite backcountry ski areas, skiing the line, another dead end line, just great snow that day. And end of April, what can you say, but a powder day and face shots in the end of April.
I need a vest on, last of a dying breed. MC's the MC speak of reality. I see life's chemistry, world is a melting pot. Hip hop connects the dots, teach them cause the music don't stop. That's all we got, shots fly every day. Duck, you might get to stray, struck, just move out the way, or you fall to your face. Drunk off Alizé, yet you still drove away. DUI is the case, the murder case, disgrace, to the race. We battle for a place in society's food chain. No blackface, no shackles, rope chains. Some we still slaves, days by the diamonds, the cars, the cocaine. I'm fighting for my free speech, can't get too deep. I need to dumb my music down if I wanna reach the masses.
The masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses.
I'm fighting for my free speech, can't get too deep. I need to dumb my music down if I wanna reach the masses.
The masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses, the masses.
Traveling on the road. Why? Why travel on the road? I mean, when you could fly or take the train or anything like that. I think for me and for really anyone who's done it, it's the perspectives that you get, the perspectives that you gain. You know, when you're up there on an airplane, you're kind of popping in and out of cities and the whole landscape's there below you. But oftentimes you're so far above the clouds, you can't really see anything. So the time that you spend traveling really doesn't hold on to you quite as well as when you're on the road. When you're driving a vehicle or even sitting shotgun in a car or a van, there's nothing like the landscape as it changes around you. You're in it. First time I've ever been able to strap my skis on my back and hop on a snowmobile. And definitely some things I learned along the way, but you know, all in all, I think it worked out pretty well.
Don't get stuck, Tats!
My name is Chris Tatsuna. I'm a professional big mountain skier and a full-time van living ski bum.
Needed a guide like a blind veteran's dog, cause I was going nowhere like a child's letters to God. The life's road was hard, I was never so lost that I looked for an answer and I met as a boss. I never did pop pills or cocktails, just rock tills. Kids with skills still got a rasp for cops still. They had me in the back of a paddy, down the locker, smack me, pat me down for a bag. Mom's a rocker and bail me out. I figure out once again next weekend, bail me out drunk again. And I never will forgive myself for putting you through all that hell. I went from high school dropout to factory laborer, slave to the clock until 4. Went from sleeping on the floor to being out on tour. Now no stopping me, I'll finish with a bang like a Cobain's biography.
Going down the hard road,
down the high road.
If I never had bail, maybe I'll be dead or in jail. Well, man, I got no one else to blame. I'll thank my family and music for keeping me sane. But that's the breaks, right? Started working late nights, never seeing daylight, getting paid like a slave might. And I've done too many years to miss this for my missus to have to tell my son he nearly never existed.
Going down.
tail of a high road.
Spirit of truth, cause all these kids that I meet, man, they mirror my youth. And I could have gone the wrong way,
the easy option,
but I chose to go the long way.
So
keep a lookout, look out, be ballers, keep your hook up, pull a page, rip my book out, and pull out your finger, put your foot out. And keep a lookout for what we put out, the brand new flavor for your cookout.
What's happening? I'm Max Kushai, live in Salt Lake City, Utah, originally from the East Coast, and I'm a professional free skier, base jumper extraordinaire. Season was pretty fun, got to do a lot of cool things I've been looking at doing the past 3 years. I got to do a ski base that I've been looking forward to do up in Alta, and did a couple other ski bases around the Utah area that was really fun.
Had a really fun trip out to Europe this year. Went to Switzerland, to a little valley I've been to a couple times. Actually did my first few base jumps there and went back to do some wingsuit base jumping. Did a fun jump this winter. Got a little urban with parachutes and climbed up a crane and hopped off it. We just like to go out there and have a good time. It's non-stop entertainment when the two of us get together and get out there.
Tyson Bolda, man, so many things to say about him, but if I had to narrow it down, Tyson is a professional.
Gonna go dominate something. Don't yet know what to dominate, but it will be dominated.
My name's Tyson Bolduc. I'm from Vail, Colorado. I'm an aspiring dolphin trainer, but I decided to be a skier instead.
Tyson knows what he wants, and he chases it down, and he wants people to be part of his program, which is good. So he brings people along and gets the action going, keeps us motivated. The thing about Tyson is that when you get him outdoors, that's him in his element, and it's awesome to see. You know, get him all geared up and on his skis, and he's just hooting and hollering session, just a big old fun bag, ready to send it down the next pit and come out laughing.
3, 2, 1, dropping.
We can make it roll. I'm singing, we can make it slow. Stop it, stupid.
Sometimes in an extreme sport you experience setbacks, and this year I experienced a setback. I jumped a cliff and landed a little bit off kilter with my elbow between my knee and my chest, so the snow was firmer than I expected and my knee compressed up to my chest and smashed my elbow into my ribs. So I broke a couple ribs but didn't realize that they were broken until later on when we had driving the snowmobiles out the valley to go get some friends, and I got the snowmobile stuck. So I climbed over the snowmobile to try to go help my friend dig it out a little bit of what motion I was able to do at the time, and I slipped on the seat. Brand new snowmobile, so the seat was nice and smooth, I found out, and I took the handlebar to my chest, which separated the three ribs that were broken, and simultaneously felt each and every rib poke out of the skin of my chest, and I've never been in such excruciating pain until the next morning when I woke up and the Dramamine had worn off and I got the hiccups. And I'll never forget sitting in bed with the hiccups, crying, watching my chest move every time I hiccuped. That is why we're skiers.
Faces, spacious, sky stay high and gracious. Patience, make me feel time is wasted. Came so close that I could almost taste it. Switch it up was to change the game plan, to put it on you like a Nike name brand. Until you give it up and let the respect change hands, it'll never be the same, man.
It's a frustrating sport that we're all involved with. There's so much involved that is behind the scenes. And it's frustrating because a lot of the time when you're with a group, people lose sense, or they lose the real meaning of why we're out in the backcountry playing around, and there's so much pressure to get the shot, and there's so many internal desires that people are self-driven or self-motivated to get out and accomplish something that they've been wanting to do, whether it's a jump or a rail or skiing a line that is only snowed in for 2 days out of the season.
We'll be right back.
how I spend my time.
What I work vigorously for.
To earn this great privilege.
And with the sacrifice comes great victory.
Victory in progress, new friends, and another great accomplishment.
With my season over,
I attempt to return to my regular life, yet often spending my time
finishing edits,
blogs, and planning for the upcoming season.
And as the hard work would have it,
all of us have yielded a new achievement,
reaching to higher levels.
We all worked as individuals,
yet coming together to reach this feat
by uniting, collaborating, and moreover having fun.
Aside from any differences,
we all seem to harmonize for this so-called job.
With yet another year under our belts,
this is our message that we are here.
That we are here.
We are here. This is our
declaration.
We'll be right back.